Waiting is the worst. It can be annoying, distressing, even just painful. Whether it's on the phone or in a physical line or waiting for a page to load, it's no fun. In fact, our own Don Norman has written about the psychology of waiting lines. Great article linked below. In the digital context, progress indicators are a big help with waiting. They tell users that the system needs more time to process that last user action. And sometimes they'll even tell us about how much time is left. It's hardly a new concept, but it's worth reiterating because this is a human need that isn't going to change anytime soon. There are a few kinds of progress indicators that we tend to see. The first is looped animation. This is your classic spinner. It's probably what you think of when you think of a wait animation. Anything that is a simple animation that just replays continuously such that you never notice the start or the end, that's what we're talking about. A lot of companies today will actually use branded spinners, you know, where part of the company logo is bouncing or twirling around. That's fine, you know, as long as it conveys to users that the system is still working. Use these animations for the shortest wait times, like any responses that are going to take up to a few seconds. Any longer than that, and people might start to question whether or not the system is stuck. Another type of common progress indicator is the percent done animation. This is an animation with a clear start and end point. It might be a bar or some other shape that fills to completion, thus conveying, you know, how much time is left until the system has finished. Note here that these are best for longer wait times when people will actually have the time while they're waiting to be able to follow along with that progress. And they can notice, oh, look, you know, 21 of my 100 images are uploaded, or, oh, here we go, we're up to 34, great. Whether or not you need to show the numeric percent or numbers will vary by context. In some cases, like with individual files being uploaded, users might be comforted knowing that each file is accounted for. The trick here is not to underestimate the time to completion. People can happily wait as they see a progress moving steadily toward finish, but if it hangs on 99%, it can be really frustrating. On the other hand, if it ends up going a lot faster at the end, well, great, user has some seconds of their life back. I'll also say, please avoid showing completion only to restart it from the beginning. That is actually a looped animation that's disguised as a percent done animation, and it's really unfair to the human on the other side of that. Progressive page loading is another type of progress indicator. This is a technique that doesn't involve a specific graphic per se, but rather it conveys progress by steadily loading in content as it becomes available. Just like popcorn, some page elements are ready sooner than others. Here, pages use placeholders and load heading text or maybe the dominant color of an image. Some sites even optimize the top task buttons to load before full images and larger files. This can work great because then users can actually begin their task while the rest of the page is filling in. Progress indicators aren't a new concept. They're still around and as important as ever because as long as there are instances where people have to wait, there will be a need to show users progress.